So good morning guys, welcome back to Has Learned. My name is Aman Kumar, I am your physics faculty for JEE and NEET. So once again welcome back. Today is a very special class because I am providing you the solution of, or we are providing you the solution of this IIT JEE mains 2000 paper complete solution. Okay, because all of you know that this JEE mains paper 19 is very near, in the next month only. So most of you guys are searching for this JEE mains 2018 complete solution. So we Has Learned faculties are providing you the complete solution of this IIT JEE mains paper, that is 2018, and that is a very important topic. Why? Because dekho, you need to understand what type of question are coming in nowadays. Okay, that is a very important. Ki dekho kaisa problem aa raha hai, you need to analyze that, which type of problem is coming, what is the level of problem, that is the very important. Okay, so in today class I'm going to talk about the all the things like how you should prepare for the final exam, final maths, that is very important, right? And also I will tell you the what is the trick behind the every problems. So stay tuned to the Has Learned for such type of videos, that is a very important. Okay, we will provide you the best materials, best videos, best classes in the future only. So today stay tuned with this class only. So let's have a goal of the today class. In today class I'm going to talk about this IIT JEE mains 2000 paper, that is the related to physics only. So I will give you the solution of physics, not the mathematics and not the chemistry, only physics, all the 34 problems, and these problems are from the set B. Okay, now so let's move to the first problem, that is a very important problem. It is from the collision part. Okay, as all of you know the what is the concept behind the collision, because I'm not going to talk about the whole concept here. I will only discuss the what is the formula, what is the concept behind this problem. Okay, so now let's move to the first problem, that is the, here it is, and what is given, you need to understand first ki what is the given in the problem. See, it is here only, it is found that if a neutron suffer an elastic collision, collinear collision with deuterium at rest, fractional loss of its energy is pd. It means the fractional loss, final loss in kinetic energy divided by the initial kinetic energy, that is called fractional loss of its energy. Because dekho yahan pe jab bhi ye collision karega to iske paas only, it will have only kinetic energy, right? While for its similar collision with carbon nucleus at the rest, again dekho yahan pe in the first case neutron is colliding with the deuterium, that is at rest. In the second case it is colliding with the carbon nucleus, it is also rest. Fractional loss of its energy is pc here, that is for carbon, with the carbon. Okay, the value of pc and pd is respectively, you need to find the value of pd and pc here. Ab dekho how you will approach this problem. This is a case of elastic collinear collision. Dekho, there are two, suppose this is here only, this is neutron, this is deuterium. Ab yahan pe let's assume that the velocity is v here and this is velocity is zero here. Why? Because it is at rest. After collision let's assume that this neutron having a velocity of v1, this is neutron, and this deuterium having a velocity of v2 here. अब देखो यहाँ पे एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेज ऑफ माई हैज डन क्लास की वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट द कोलिजन इट्स मोमेंटम विल कंसर्व बिकॉज इन कोलिजन देर इज नो एनी एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज एक्टिंग इन दैट केस एफ नेट शुड बी जीरो सो दैट इज वाई दिस मोमेंटम विल कंसर्व हियर सो आई कैन राइट एम वी प्लस जीरो दैट इज इक्वल टू एम वी वन प्लस अब वाट इज द मास ऑफ ड्यूटेरियम इट इज द डबल ऑफ द न्यूट्रॉन सो आई कैन से दैट इट शुड बी 2m into v2 here, that is equation number 1. Ab dekho yahan pe this is a case of elastic collision. In that case this coefficient of restitution will be 1, and what is the formula of a coefficient of restitution? It is velocity of separation divided by velocity of approach here. So I can say that this will be v2 minus v1 divided by v, that is equal to 1. So from here you will get v2 minus v1, that is v here. This is equation number 2. This m and m will get cancelled out in the equation number 1. अब देखो यहाँ पे फ्रॉम इक्वेशन नंबर 1 एंड 2 देयर इज ओनली टू अननोन दैट इज v1 एंड v2 वी नीड टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ v1 एंड v2 सो हियर यू विल गेट फ्रॉम हियर फ्रॉम 1 एंड 2 v1 इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच दैट इज माइनस v/3 हियर सो दिस इज द फाइनल वेलोसिटी ऑफ द न्यूट्रॉन आफ्टर कोलिजन हियर दिस इज द फाइनल वेलोसिटी ऑफ द न्यूट्रॉन आफ्टर कोलिजन नाउ अब देखो यहाँ पे we have to find the fractional loss of its energy. It means we have to find the fractional loss of neutron energy. So I will write it here pd, that is pd. So pd equal to how much? That is half m v square minus half m v1 square divided by half m v square. अब देखो यहाँ पे half of it will cancel out. This is also get cancelled out. You will get v square minus v1 square divided by v square. That is the value of PD here. And PD is how much? अब देखो यहाँ पे v is minus v/3. So I can say that v1 is how much? That is minus v/3. So it should be v square minus v square by 9 divided by v square. From here we will get the final value, that is 0.89. देखो अब this is the PD value, but we have to find the value of PC also. That is the collision with the carbon nucleus. So again we will apply the same formula, same approach here. Okay, suppose this is the neutron here, moving with a velocity v, having mass m here. This is another carbon nucleus. अब देखो यहाँ पे carbon nucleus having a mass of 12 m, just the 12 times. So it should be 12 m. Its velocity is 0, but after collision, this is after collision, or you can say after elastic collision. So here after collision it should be mv1, or here it is 12 mv2. Just assume that the velocity is v1 and here it is v2 here. Dekho, again apply the same formula, same concept. You will get this v1 equal to how much? It should be, you will get v1 equal to minus 11 upon 13 v. Kaise? Dekho, yahan pe bhi same apply karo, that momentum conserve karo, and this is the case of elastic collision. So just apply the velocity of separation divided by velocity of approach, that is equal to 1, and you will get two equations here. From 1 and 2 you will get v1, that is in case of second one, that is minus 11 by 13 into v. Again apply the same formula, that is PC equal to how much? That is half m v square minus half m v1 square divided by half m v square. From here you will get the value of v square minus v1 square divided by v square. Put on the value of v1 square here, you will get PC equal to how much? It should be 0.21. कैसे? देखो यहाँ पे जब आप v1 की वैल्यू पुट करोगे, इन दैट केस दिस v विल गेट कैंसल आउट, यू विल गेट समथिंग लाइक दिस वन. आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन यू विल गेट 0.28. सो हियर वी कैन से दैट कि vc इक्वल टू हाउ मच. अब देखो pd इक्वल टू 0.89, दैट इज दिस वन, एंड pc इक्वल टू 0.28, दैट इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी आई एम गेटिंग. एंड लेट अस टेक व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर. इट इज सी ऑप्शन. देखो इन JEE मेंस बहुत ज्यादा टफ क्वेश्चन नहीं आता है, ठीक है. They just nowadays they just want to check your basic concept, whether your basic concept is clear or not. यहाँ पे देखो कुछ भी नहीं था, यहाँ पे बस ये था कि for elastic collision your coefficient of restitution should be 1, and in case of collision your momentum should be conserved. And you need to remember also that what is the mass of deuterium, what is the mass of carbon as compared to neutron. ठीक है, let us move to the next problem, that is question number 2 here. It is now here. Here the mass of the hydrogen molecule is given, that is 3.32 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. If 10⁻²³ hydrogen molecule strike per second at a fixed wall of area 2 cm² at an angle of 45 to the normal and rebound elastically with the speed of 10⁻³ meter per second, find the pressure on the wall. Dekho yahan pe suppose this is the wall here and there is a one normal here. Ab yahan pe it is given that कि ऑल द हाइड्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल स्ट्राइक एट एन एंगल ऑफ 45 टू द नॉर्मल. इट मीन्स कि दे विल स्ट्राइक एट एन एंगल ऑफ, दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट लुकिंग लाइक नॉर्मल, यस इट शुड बी लाइक दिस एंड दिस वन, एंड द एंगल इज गिवन दैट इज 45 डिग्री. अब यहाँ पे देखो अगर मैं बात करूँ कि यहाँ पे सपोज इट स्ट्राइकिंग विद द वेलोसिटी ऑफ वी हियर एंड इट इज कोलाइडिंग इलास्टिकली. अब देखो यहाँ से सेम रिबाउंड करेगा, यहाँ पे द एंगल अगेन एंगल विल बी 45. सो आई कैन से दैट अगर आप इस डायरेक्शन में डायग्राम बनाओगे, इसको एक्सटेंड कराओगे, दिस वन लाइक दिस, एंड व्हाट इज द एंगल हियर? एंगल विल बी अगेन इट शुड बी 45 हियर. सो इन दिस डायरेक्शन व्हाट इज द एंगल मोमेंटम? दैट इज द एम वी कॉस 45 फॉर दिस वन. इन दिस डायरेक्शन इट शुड बी एम वी साइन 45. What about this one? Again, it is moving with the velocity v here. So in this direction, again it should be mv sine 45, and in this direction it should be for this one mv cos 45. अब देखो अगर आप net momentum निकालोगे on this wall, तो देखो ये जो x direction में है, that mv cos 45 and mv cos 45, they will cancel out each other, but net momentum will get in the negative y direction, that is 2 mv sine 45. So I can say that p net equal to how much? That is 2 mv sine 45. अब देखो कैसे निकालोगे. यू हैव टू फाइंड द प्रेशर ऑन द वॉल. एंड व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर प्रेशर? इट इज नेट फोर्स पर यूनिट एरिया. अब हाउ यू कैलकुलेट द नेट फोर्स? देखो दिस इज द नेट मोमेंटम फॉर ए सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल. बट देयर आर इट हाउ मच 10^23 हाइड्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल स्ट्राइक पर सेकेंड. तो अगर मैं इसे ऐसे करूं कि एफ नेट इक्वल टू एन बाई टी इंटू पी नेट, देन यू विल गेट. देखो कैसे रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम इक्वल टू नेट फोर्स, दैट इज एन बाई टी इंटू पी नेट. इट शुड बी एन इंटू 2mv साइन 45. दैट इज द एफ नेट. ओके दैट इज एन बाई टू. एंड एन बाई टू इक्वल टू हाउ मच? दैट इज 10^23. सो प्रेशर इक्वल टू हाउ मच? प्रेशर इक्वल टू एफ नेट डिवाइडेड बाई एरिया एयर. अब यहां पे देखिए एन इज हाउ मच? एन इज गिवन 10^23 इंटू 2 इंटू मास इज हाउ मच? मास इज गिवन 3.32 इंटू 10^-27. एनीथिंग एल्स? यस. इंटू वी, वी इज हाउ मच? वेलोसिटी इज 10^3 डिवाइडेड बाई साइन 45 इज 1/√2 इंटू एरिया. एरिया इज 2 cm², दैट्स 2 × 10^-4. फ्रॉम हियर यू विल फाइंड प्रेशर. नेट प्रेशर इक्वल टू हाउ मच? इट विल बी आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन यू विल गेट 2.35 × 10^3 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. सो पी इक्वल टू हाउ मच? दैट इज 2.35 × 10^3 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. एंड दैट इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी ऑप्शन. ओके तो देखो यहाँ पे बेसिकली यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि देखो यहाँ पे एक्स कंपोनेंट विल गेट कैंसल आउट, द कंपोनेंट ऑफ द मोमेंटम विल कैंसल आउट इन एक्स डायरेक्शन, द नेट मोमेंटम यू विल गेट ओनली इन द वाई डायरेक्शन. एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 2mv sin 45°. ठीक है. सो लेट अस सी व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर. दैट इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी इज द राइट वन. नाउ लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 3 हियर. दैट इज हियर ओनली. See what is given. A solid sphere of radius r made up of a soft material of bulk modulus k is surrounded by a liquid in a cylinder container, a massless piston of area a. Here this is area a here. Float on the surface of the liquid covering entire cross section of the cylindrical container. And what is cylindrical container? It is here only. When a mass m is placed on the surface of the piston to compress the liquid, the fractional decrement in the radius of the sphere. You have to find the fractional decrement in the area of the sphere. But first of all, what is the formula for bulk modulus? It is bulk modulus, I can say that k equal to delta p divided by minus of delta v upon v. Understood everyone? Minus of delta v upon v. Ab dekho, how you can find the delta p? Delta p is the change in pressure. Change in pressure because, what is the reason for change in pressure? It is due to mass m here, because you are placing a mass on the piston. And because of this mass piston, it will exert a gravity force on the piston. Because of that, it will compress the liquid here. So I can say that this delta P is how much? Delta P equal to mg by A here. And what about delta V upon V? What is the expression for V here? V is the volume of the solid sphere. And we know that V equal to 4/3 πr³. So delta V upon V equal to 3 delta R upon R. This is the concept of unit and dimension. As it explained you in my classes, that error classes, that how you can find the relative error. That is delta V upon V is 3 delta R upon R, and where delta R upon R is the fractional decrement in the radius of the sphere here. So I can say that here, so k equal to how much? K equal to mg upon A into, what is the delta V upon V? That is 3 delta r upon r with negative sign. Ab dekho yahan pe negative sign denotes that this radius is decreasing here, that is why it is decrement. So I can say that delta r upon r equal to mg upon 3 ka. Within 30 seconds you can solve this problem only. And this is the problem of JEE mains 2018 final paper. Dekho kitna easy paper aata hai. If you know the concept, you can easily solve within 30 seconds. And this is the problem of physics. Understood? Dekho yahan pe. So delta R upon R is mg upon 3 ka, that is option number A here, mg upon 3 ka. Let us check which one is the right answer. It is A only, that is the decrement in the radius. Understood everyone? Fine. Next one, that is a problem number 4. Two batteries with EMF 12 volt and 13 volt are connected in parallel across a load resistor 10 ohm. देखो यहाँ पे two batteries with EMF 12 volt and 13 volt are connected in parallel across a load resistor of 10 ohm. देखो तो पहले तो कुछ दो बैटरी लगाओ. This is one battery here and this is an with यहाँ पे एक internal resistance भी जोड़ दो. They are connected through a parallel connection, that is this one, and this is connected through the external resistance here. Okay, and what is the value of external resistance? That is 10 ohm, and here it is. This first one is 1 ohm, second one is 2 ohm here, and its value is 12 volt, it is 13 volt here. Ab dekho. Find the voltage across the load. It means you have to find the, suppose this is A and this is B, you have to find the potential difference between the point A and P, that is VA minus VB here. Ab how you will calculate this one? Pahle to just try to find the equivalent potential, equivalent EMF of the two batteries they are connected in series. So I can say that V equivalent, or you can say E equivalent also, that is equal to E1 upon R1 plus E2 upon R2 divided by 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Or agar aapko shortcut yaad hai, E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2, that is the E equivalent. Theek hai, dekho ab yahan pe put on the values of this one. E1 equal to how much? E1 equal to 12 into R2 is how much? It is 2 plus E2 is 13 into 1 divided by 2 plus 1 3. So from here you can find the value of E equivalent, that is, I'm just writing here only. How much it should be? It should be 12.33. See, I'm not going to solve all the, like, I'm not going to do calculation here because it will take a lot of time. So 12.33 volt, that is the value of equivalent EMF of the battery. And how you can find the equivalent resistance of these two EMF or two batteries, that is R equivalent equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 here, that is a 1 into 2 divided by 3. You will get some values here, that is 2 by 3. Just let's take 2 by 3 here. Ab dekho yahan pe, yahan pe we got the equivalent voltage for these two batteries. So I can replace this diagram with this one. I can say that this is resistance and this is one batteries, and it is connected through the one external load here. So here it is R equivalent, here it is V equivalent, and this is load, external load is how much? That is 10 ohm. Ab yahan pe you can see that this 10 ohm and R equivalent are connected in series connection. So in series connection, current should be equal through each resistor. So I can say that this current through R equivalent and current through this 10 ohm, it should be equal. So I can say V equivalent divided by R equivalent equal to VAB, just take this point A and B, divided by 10 ohm. And V equivalent is how much? That is 12.33 divided by R equivalent is how much? That is 2 by 3 equal to VAB divided by 10. From here you can find the VAB, that is how much it will be? It will be 11.55 volt here. 11.55 volt. Let us check which one is the right answer actually. That is 11.55 volt is there. Yes, it is this one. Ab dekho, voltage across the load lies between, it should be equal to how much? Yes, it should be in T. Dekho yahan pe, not this one actually. 11.55, we are getting 11.55. It lies between the option number D here. So it should be D option. Okay. Because we got 11.55, it is lies between 11.5 and 11.6. Or you can take average of these two also, like, okay. So let us move to the next one, that is question number 5 here. And 5 is this one only. And see what is given in the problem. A particle is moving in a circular path of radius A under the action of an attracting potential U equal to minus K upon 2 R square. Find the total energy. Ab dekho, what is the expression for total energy here? Total energy, I can say that it is kinetic energy plus potential energy. And potential energy is already given, that minus K upon 2 R square. Okay. Ab dekho, how you can find the kinetic energy? So first of all, you you just have to remember the formula of kinetic energy, that is half m v square. अब देखिए यहाँ पे, this particle is moving in a circular path. It means there should be one centripetal force F. So F equal to m v square upon r here. That is the centripetal force if particle is doing this circular motion. And how you can find the value of F? We know that F equal to minus du upon dr. So I can say that it should be minus du upon dr. Or rate of change of potential energy. That is equal to how much? It should be k upon r cube. कैसे इसको अगर differentiate करोगे this potential वाले को, तो minus k into 2 into minus k into 2 upon r cube. So it will, you will get k upon r cube, that is equal to m v square upon r here. अब देखो यहाँ पे r से r get cancelled, so it should be square. So I can say that m v square equal to how much? It should be k upon r square. So basically kinetic energy, that is k e equal to how much? It should be half m v square. So you will get k upon 2r square. अब देखिए यहाँ पे kinetic energy we got k upon 2r square, potential energy is given minus k upon 2r square. So I can say that E equal to net energy, that is the total energy, equal to k upon 2r square minus k upon 2r square. You will get 0 here. This is the problem of JEE mains paper 2018. देखो कितना easy problem आता है बच्चों. बच्चों बस तुम्हें basic concept clear करना है, कैसे जो भी class में मैंने पढ़ाया है या फिर आपके रेस्पेक्टिव टीचर ने पढ़ाया है, बस आपको वही रिवाइज करना है. कुछ भी एक्स्ट्रा नहीं पढ़ना है, बहुत ज़्यादा डिटेल में नहीं पढ़ना है. यहाँ पे कुछ था ही है, देखिए यू नीड जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर द टोटल एनर्जी इक्वल टू काइनेटिक एनर्जी प्लस पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, दैट्स ऑल. एंड यू नो दैट कि दिस एफ नेट इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, दैट इज द डी यू अपॉन डी आर, दैट्स ऑल. एंड यू विल गेट 0 1. सो वेर इज द ऑप्शन 0? यस, इट इज ए ऑप्शन. लेट अस चेक व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर. इट इज ऑप्शन नंबर ए, दैट्स ऑल. बहुत ज़्यादा डीप में पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है फॉर JEE मेंस पेपर. हाँ, एडवांस के लिए डीप नॉलेज होना चाहिए, बट मेंस के लिए आपको बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर होना चाहिए. ठीक है, चलो लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट फ्रॉम दैट प्रॉब्लम नंबर 6. इट्स आल्सो वेरी इजी वन एक्चुअली. आई शुड से इट विल टेक ओनली द 2 मिनट्स, नॉट 2 मिनट्स, सॉरी, इट विल टेक ओनली 30 सेकेंड्स. कैसे? टू मासेस M1 एंड M2 10 kg कनेक्टेड बाई इन एक्सटेंसिबल स्ट्रिंग. एंड वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इन एक्सटेंसिबल स्ट्रिंग? इट मीन्स दिस टेंशन शुड बी सेम, इट इज नॉट स्ट्रेचेबल. This value of tension should be same. Over a frictionless pulley, there is no any friction, are moving as shown in the figure. The coefficient of friction of the horizontal surface is 0.15. Here coefficient of friction is given 0.15. Find the minimum weight M. That should be, it should be minimum mass, it should be mass, not weight actually. Because see the unit, it is in kg only. So it should be minimum mass M. That should be put on top of M2 to stop the motion. To stop the motion. अब देखिए यहाँ पे, who is going to stop this motion? अगर ये M1 नीचे आएगा तो M2 will move in the forward direction. But अगर इसको oppose करना है, अगर मुझे motion को oppose करना है, in that case, friction will act in the backward direction. Getting my point? Only friction is responsible for opposing this motion, because you are not putting any external force, or you are not keeping any external force. So I can say that, अब यहाँ पे जो friction आएगा, that is mu into N here, or you can say F. अब अगर इस मोशन को अपोज करना है, इन दैट केस दिस एफ शुड बी मोर देन इक्वल टू M1g. इतना तो अंडरस्टूड है कि यहाँ पे जो टी पे जो फोर्स लगा, दैट इज M1g. तो इसका जो मैग्नीट्यूड होना चाहिए फ्रिक्शन का, इट शुड बी मोर देन इक्वल टू M1g. इक्वल पे भी हो सकता है, आई एम नॉट डिनाइंग दैट कि इट शुड नॉट बी इक्वल. इट इक्वल पे भी होगा कि अब अगर मान लो यहाँ पे मैंने 2 न्यूटन का इस डायरेक्शन फोर्स लगाया, 2 न्यूटन का इस डायरेक्शन फोर्स लगाया, तो नेट फोर्स यहाँ पे 0 होगा, तो बॉडी विल बी इन इक्विलिब्रियम. तो इक्वल भी यू कैन से. F is how much? F is mu into N. N is how much? N is M plus M2 into G, that is equal to more than M1G here. Okay, now let us move to the next one. GG get cancelled out. I can say that we have to find the value of M here, right? So it should be mu M plus mu M2, it is more than M1. Or I can say that M should be more than equal to M minus mu M2 divided by mu here. And what is it should be 1, right? Yes, M1 minus mu M2 divided by mu here. And what is the value of M1? M1 is given, that is 5 minus 10 into 0.15 divided by this mu is 0.15. From here, after calculation, you will get this M should be greater than equal to 23.33 kg here. Ab yahan pe dekho, see the option, this one is cancelled out. 10.3 is not possible. 18.3 is also not possible. We are getting 43.3 and 27.3. So minimum weight, it should be 27.3 here only. We can take minimum weight. Agar yahan puchega maximum weight, so yahan pe you have to take this 14.3 kg, but we are asking about, we have to find the minimum weight. So option number D is the right one. Let us take which one is the right answer. Actually, it is option number D here. Ab dekho, yahan pe there is nothing given in this problem. It's a very easy one, very basic one. Agar aap SC Verma bana ke bhi jaoge, wahan pe aap isko easily solve kar sakte ho. Theek hai? Let us move to the next problem, that is question number 7 here. If the series limit frequency of the Lyman series is given VL, find the series limit frequency of the Pfund series. Ab yahan pe aapko ek concept clear hona chahiye ki aap in Lyman series you are moving from the infinity to n2 equal to infinity to n1 equal to 1 here. That is for Lyman series. Pfund series ke liye kya hoga? Pfund ke liye hoga aapko n2 equal to infinity to n1 equal to 1. This is the concept of Pfund, Lyman for Lyman. Balmer ke liye kya hoga? N2 equal to infinity to n1 equal to 2 here. Okay. Now, if the series limit frequency of the Lyman series is given VL, and what is the formula for this frequency? I can say that V equal to RC Z square 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square here. Ab dekhe yahan pe. That is the value of frequency here. VL is the frequency, or you can say that this is 1 upon lambda here. C upon lambda, we can say that. So here we are getting C upon F, yes, VL. That is the RC Z square upon into 1 upon 1 by 1, 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square. Or here it is RC Z square, it is 1 upon 1 minus 1 upon infinity. So I can say that VL should be equal to how much? That is RC Z square. Why? Because 1 upon infinity is 0 here. Theek hai bachcho, samajh aa raha hai? Now let us move to this one, the series limit frequency of the Pfund series. Dekho yahan pe humko limit nikalna hai, limit frequency, maximum and minimum. So maximum kahan se hoga? That is the infinity. So yahan pe VL equal to RC Z square. What about this one? VP. So I can say that VP equal to, again it should be RC Z square 1 upon n1 square. N1 is how much? N1 is 1 minus 1 upon, no, it should be 5. For Pfund, it should be 5. Actually, you are moving from n2 to infinity to n1 equal to 5 pe. So here it should be 1 upon 25 minus 1 upon infinity here. So here it should be RC Z square upon 25, that is the VP here. Ab dekho yahan pe. But answer is not given in terms of this one. Answer is given in terms of VL. So what is the value of VL? That is RC Z square. So I can say that it should be VL upon 25, or VP equal to VL by 25 here. Option number which one? That is a B option. Again, this is a very basic question. Anyone can solve this problem. If he remember this formula and he remember this concept. कि अगर Pfund की बात करें तो वहां पे n2 इक्वल टू इन्फिनिटी n1 इक्वल टू 5, फॉर लाइमन n2 इक्वल टू इन्फिनिटी n1 इक्वल टू 1 हियर. ओके, नाउ सो इट शुड बी VL अपॉन 25. विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 हियर. देखो अब यहां पे दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक वन एंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वन. अब यहां पे रट्टा मारना इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, कि अगर आपको इसका कॉन्सेप्ट पता है कि किसी पोलराइजर से जो इंटेंसिटी पास करता है, तो आफ्टर पासिंग थ्रू द पोलराइजर अनपोलराइज, if there is an unpolarized light hai, to wahan pe iska intensity will be half, or it should be half after one polarizer. So I can say that this is the one here, this is another here, and this is A and this is B. Theek hai, ab dekhiye yahan pe it is given that unpolarized light of intensity I passes through an ideal polarizer A. Theek hai, another identical polarizer B is placed behind A, this is here only. The intensity of light beyond B is given, that is I by 2 here. Suppose यहाँ से I intensity pass कर रहा है, तो यहाँ पे I by 2 हो रहा है. Now another identical polarizer C is placed between A and B. The intensity beyond B is now found to be I by 8. The angle between polarizer A and C. अब let's assume that the one you're placing one polarizer here, that is making an angle of theta here, and this is also theta here. अब देखो यहाँ पे suppose this is C here. जब इससे पास कराओगे तो यहां पे जो इंटेंसिटी होगा दैट विल बी आई बाई टू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा हियर, आई बाई टू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा. आफ्टर दिस वन ऑल्सो यू विल गेट आई बाई टू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा हियर. सो बेसिकली यू विल गेट आई बाई टू कॉस फोर थीटा. अब देखिए यहां पे इसकी जो वैल्यू है दैट इज सपोज लेट्स अज्यूम दैट दिस इज आई डैश हियर एंड आई डैश इज गिवन दैट इज आई बाई एट हियर इट शुड बी आई बाई एट सो आई कैन पुट दिस वन आई बाई टू इन टू कॉस फोर थीटा एंड थीटा इज द एंगल बिटवीन ए एंड सी दिस इज एंगल सो आई कैन से कॉस थीटा इक्वल टू हाउ मच इट शुड बी फोर वन अपॉन रूट टू इट मीन्स थीटा इक्वल टू 45 डिग्री थीटा इक्वल टू 45 डिग्री सो दिस विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर ए हियर लेट अस टेक व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर एक्चुअली इट इज ए ऑप्शन इट्स अ वेरी इजी वन बट देखो यहाँ पे द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट कि अगर थीटा एंगल पे होगा तो जो उसकी इंटेंसिटी होगी दैट शुड बी आई बाई टू कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा हियर और आई नॉट कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा फाइन लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 9 हियर एन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम वेरियस एक्साइटेड स्टेट ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम इमिट रेडिएशन टू कम टू द ग्राउंड स्टेट लेट डेल्टा एन एंड डेल्टा जी बी द डी ब्रोगली वेवलेंथ ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन इन nth state and the ground state. Delta L, delta N is the wavelength of the electron in nth state and delta G is the in the state of ground state. Okay. This symbol, I don't know what you should call it actually, be the wavelength of the emitted photon in the transition from the nth state to the ground state. For larger N, A and B are constant, find the relation between the delta N, let's assume it is the delta N, A plus B lambda n square delta n square equal to approx lambda delta n equal to approx a plus p upon lambda delta n square. अब देखो यहाँ पे इसको कैसे अप्रोच करोगे दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन कि देखो यहाँ पे आई कैन से दैट देयर इज वन अपॉन लैमडा एन बिकॉज देखो दिस वन इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ ओनली सो इट शुड बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच इट शुड बी इक्वल टू आर जेड स्क्वायर अब देखो यहाँ पे इन द प्रीवियस वन वी गॉट दिस फॉर्मूला कि फ्रीक्वेंसी इक्वल टू आर सी जेड स्क्वायर बट हियर वी आर डीलिंग विद द वन अपॉन डेल्टा एन दैट इज द एक्सप्रेशन वेवलेंथ सो हियर इट इज आर सी आर जेड स्क्वायर वन अपॉन एन वन स्क्वायर माइनस वन अपॉन एन टू स्क्वायर अब देखिए यहाँ पे यू आर मूविंग फ्रॉम एन एस स्टेट टू ग्राउंड स्टेट फॉर ग्राउंड स्टेट इट इज इक्वल टू वन सो आई कैन से दैट इट शुड बी आर जेड स्क्वायर इक्वल टू वन बाई वन माइनस वन अपॉन एन स्क्वायर अब यहाँ पे देखिए दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ वन अपॉन डी एन वट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डी एन लैम डेल्टा एन दैट इज इक्वल टू आई कैन से दैट इट शुड बी इक्वल टू वन अपॉन आर जेड स्क्वायर वन माइनस वन अपॉन एन स्क्वायर माइनस वन अब देखिए यहाँ पे इट इज गिवन दैट इट इज वेरी लार्ज अगर बहुत लार्ज वैल्यू देन वी कैन यूज दिस बाइनोमियल एक्सपेंशन हियर दैट इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन आर जेड स्क्वायर वन प्लस वन अपॉन एन स्क्वायर राइट नाउ सी हियर आई कैन से दैट इट शुड बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच इट शुड बी इक्वल टू 1 upon r z square plus 1 upon n square into r z square. That is the expression for lambda n, delta n. So here delta n equal to how much? अब देखिए यहाँ पे 1 upon n square. And what is the expression for this lambda n? This delta n. You know the formula delta n is proportional to n. So it should be delta n square should be proportional to n square. Right? Now, so here I can say that it should be equal to 1 upon r z square plus 1 upon this delta n square into r z square. So here I can say dn equal to, let's assume that this is a one constant here, that is a plus b upon lambda n square. Because we have to find in terms of constant a and b. So we are getting this, basically we got this formula. This delta n equal to 1 upon rz square plus 1 upon delta n square into rz square. अब देखो ऑप्शन देखो यहाँ पे ऑप्शन कैसा है कि डेल्टा n इक्वल टू a प्लस b अपॉन डेल्टा n square. तो अगर यहाँ पे हम बात करें तो वी आर ओनली गेटिंग 1 upon rz square plus 1 upon delta n square. But except this one, there is no any term of this one dividing. So this will be option number C here. Okay? Let us move to the question number 9. Option number C is the right one. 10. The reading of the ammeter for a silicon diode in the given circuit is. देखो this one is a very easy one, but यहाँ पे आपको पता करना है this is a forward biasing or backward biasing. So this is the case of forward biasing. ठीक है, and silicon diode in case of forward biasing, there is a potential drop of 0.3 here. 0.7 I think, yes, it should be 0.7 volt. So potential drop across this. थर्मल इट शुड बी 0.7 वोल्ट. तो देखो अब यहाँ पे 0.7 वोल्ट यहाँ पे यूज हो गया. तो व्हाट इज द नेट वोल्टेज? वी नेट इक्वल टू हाउ मच? वी नेट इक्वल टू 3 माइनस 0.7 वोल्ट, दैट इज 2.3 वोल्ट. अब देखो आप निकालना क्या है, द रीडिंग ऑफ द अमीटर, अमीटर शुड बी हियर ओनली. सो आई कैन से दैट द रीडिंग ऑफ अमीटर आई इक्वल टू हाउ मच? इट शुड बी 2.3 डिवाइडेड बाय 200 ओम हियर. इट शुड बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच? इट शुड बी इक्वल टू, आई थिंक वैल्यू आई हैव रिटन समवेयर लाइक, यस इट शुड बी 11.5 मिली एम्पियर. क्लियर है? सो ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज द राइट वन. ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज द राइट वन बिकॉज सी, इन केस ऑफ फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग द पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप थ्रू द सिलिकॉन डायोड इज गिवन, दैट इज 0.7 वोल्ट. इट मींस द नेट वोल्टेज थ्रू दिस वन, दिस अमीटर शुड बी 3 माइनस 0.7, दैट इज 2.3 हियर. सो करंट थ्रू दिस रेजिस्टेंस आर इक्वल टू हाउ मच? दैट इज 2.3 अपॉन 200 ओम, दैट इज 11.5 मिली एम्पियर. अंडरस्टूड एवरी वन? फाइन. नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. बट बिफोर दैट वन लेट अस टेक व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर. इट इज ऑप्शन नंबर ए, दैट इज द राइट वन. नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन, दैट इज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 11. दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इजी वन. सी व्हाट इज गिवन, एन इलेक्ट्रॉन, ए प्रोटॉन एंड अल्फा पार्टिकल हैविंग द सेम काइनेटिक एनर्जी आर मूविंग इन द सर्कुलर ऑर्बिट ऑफ रेडियाई आर ई आर पी एंड आर अल्फा respectively in a uniform magnetic field of B. The relation between the Re, Rp, R alpha is. अब यहाँ पे आपको एक फॉर्मूला याद होना चाहिए कि what is the radius of the moving electron or moving particle, that is R equal to I can say mv upon qb. This is the expression for radius, that is R equal to mv upon qe, or we can say under root 2m ke divided by qb. Why? Because देखो यहाँ पे it is given same kinetic energy for all particle. So we have to change this expression mv upon qb in terms of kinetic energy here, right? So here it should be 2m ke upon qb, that is the value of r. Let us talk about the radius re. Re equal to how much? It should be equal to under root 2m e k divided by eb. Why? Because charge on the electron is e here. What is the value of r? P. It should be equal to almost 2mp into k divided by charge on the proton is eb here. Charge on the proton is eb. What about r alpha? R alpha is how much? Ab yahan pe dekho, 2 into 4mp. Why? Because alpha particle, mass of the alpha particle is 4 times the mass of the proton here. That is into k divided by eb. Right? Yes, यहाँ पे what is the charge on the alpha particle? That is 2 times of charge on the electron. That is 2e here. So it should be, अब यहाँ पे देखो under root 4 and 2, it will cancel out. You will get 2mp into k divided by eb. That is the value of r alpha here. अब यहाँ पे let us compare. R alpha is how much? Under root 2mp k upon eb. Rp equal to 2mp k upon eb. And re equal to 2me k upon eb. So I can say that this rp equal to r alpha. And mass of proton is more than mass of electron, so it should be radius should be more than mass radius of electron here. So Re, Rp equal to R alpha, and it should be more than Re here. So option number which one is the right one? Option number Re, Rp, option number D here. Understood? So देखो this one is a very easy one. देखो यहाँ पे अभी तक आपको ये समझ में आ रहा होगा कि कितना basic question आता है exam में. अगर आपने पूरा syllabus अगर अच्छे से पढ़ा है, कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करके पढ़ा है, नॉट लाइक जस्ट ऊपर ऊपर देख लिया. अगर आपका बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट बहुत क्लियर है तो आप आराम से कर सकते हो पेपर में स्कोर. ठीक है, 70% कोई भी नहीं रोकेगा आपको एग्जाम में स्कोर करने में फिजिक्स के लिए, कि आजकल पेपर जो आता है बहुत ईजी रहता है. तो लेट अस चेक व्हिच वन इज द राइट आंसर. ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज द राइट वन. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 here. ए पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस 9 पिको फैराड इज कनेक्टेड टू अ बैटरी ऑफ ईएमएफ 20 वोल्ट. इफ ए डायलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल ऑफ द डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट k 5/3 इज इंसर्टेड बिटवीन द प्लेट्स, द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द इंड्यूस्ड चार्ज विल बी. अब देखो यहां पे यू हैव टू फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड चार्ज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट. सो लेट्स अज्यूम q इक्वल टू c into v. What is the q dash after inducing this dielectric constant? It should be k times c into v. So net induced charge, it will be q dash minus q, that is the k cv minus cv here. It should be c CV into K minus 1. Just put on the values of 19 picofarad, 19 into 10 raised to how much? It should be minus 12 into voltage is how much? That is 20. And K by 3, 5 by 3 minus 1, you will get here Q dash. That is, let's assume it is delta Q. That is the amount of charge induced. It is equal to how much? It's 1.2 nanocoulomb. This should be 1.2 nanocoulomb here. That is option number C. That is the right one. Next, 13 one. अब देखो ये बहुत ही इजी प्रॉब्लम है. मैंने अपनी क्लास में बताया है कि व्हाट इज द क्वालिटी फैक्टर. इट शुड बी ओमेगा नॉट एल अपॉन आर. दिस इज द डायरेक्ट फॉर्मुला फॉर दिस क्वालिटी फैक्टर. और यू कैन से दिस इज फॉर्मुला फॉर दिस वन डेल्टा और ओमेगा नॉट अपॉन डेल्टा ओमेगा नॉट. दैट इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा नॉट एल अपॉन आर. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ क्वालिटी फैक्टर. सो इट इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी इज द राइट वन. नो नीड टू डिस्कस मोर अबाउट दिस प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज दिस इज द डायरेक्ट फॉर्मुला फॉर क्वालिटी फैक्टर हियर. Next one, a telephonic communication service is working at a carrier frequency of 10 gigahertz. Only 10% of it is utilized for transmission. Ab dekho yahan pe 10 gigahertz ka only 10% is utilized. How many telephonic channel can be transmitted simultaneously if each channel require a bandwidth of 5 kilohertz? Ab dekho how many telephonic channel, iske liye direct formula hai ki number of telephonic channel equal to NCERT ki sabse last chapter ko padh lena, wahan se bahut hi easy problem aata hai. Direct wahan pe formula likha hua hai number of telephonic channels equal to total bandwidth divided by channel अब देखिए total bandwidth कितना होगा 10 gigahertz का 10 only percent बस only transmission के लिए 10% चाहिए. so I can say 10 into 10 raised to 9 into 10 by 100 divided by and channel bandwidth kitna 5 kilohertz. it should be 5 into 10 raised to 3. from here we will get the value of this one, that is 2 into 10 raised to 5 here. that is the number of telephonic channel. that is option number A here. it is option number A. now move to the question number 15 here. ab iske liye there is a direct formula. what is given? a granite rod of 60 cm length is clamped at its middle point. here it is clamped at middle point and it is set into longitudinal vibration here. the density of the granite is given 2.7 into 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube and its Young's modulus is given, that is 9.27 into 10 raised to 10 pascal here. ab dekhiye yahan pe what is the fundamental frequency of the longitudinal vibration. ab jab aap isko rod ko clamp karke middle point pe vibration mein daloge, there is a formula for this one, that is f equal to c by lambda, that is equal to 1 upon 2l under root gamma upon rho here. now what is the length? length should be 1 upon 2 into centimeter है, तो इसको मीटर में कन्वर्ट कर लो, into under root gamma. gamma is how much? gamma is 9.27 into 10 raised to 10 divided by 2.7 into 10 raised to 3. here from here you can get the frequency, that is equal to 4.88 into 10 raised to 3 hertz. अब देखिए यहाँ पे approx value दिया हुआ है, तो I will take this 4.88 approximately 5 here. so 5 kilo hertz here, because unit is in kilohertz. option number C I am getting and this is correct one, C is only. now problem number 16 here. ab dekho ye thoda sa tough hai, bol sakte ho ki this is a very tough one. yahan pe iska level jo hai bahut zyada acha hai. sorry, अब देखिए यहाँ पे व्हाट इज गिवन. सेवन आइडेंटिकल सर्कुलर प्लेनर डिस्क, हियर इट इज 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 हियर, राइट? ईच ऑफ मास m, सो ऑल हैविंग मास ऑफ m हियर, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड ऑल हैविंग मास ऑफ m हियर एंड रेडियस r. सो हियर द रेडियस इज गिवन, दैट इज r. हियर ऑल्सो रेडियस इज r हियर. आर वेल्डेड सिमेट्रिकली एज शोन इन द फिगर. द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सी ऑफ द अरेंजमेंट अबाउट द एक्सिस normal to the plane and passing through the point P. it means you have to find the moment of inertia about this plane, this one. अब देखिए यहाँ पे अगर मुझे इस पॉइंट के अलॉन्ग मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया निकालना है, इट मीन्स आई हैव टू फाइंड द नेट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया अबाउट दिस पॉइंट ओ प्लस टोटल मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया अक्रॉस दिस वन. और आई कैन से दैट वी कैन अप्लाई दिस पैरल एक्सिस थ्योरम. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट ट्राई टू फाइंड द नेट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया अलॉन्ग दिस पॉइंट ओ, दैट इज आई नॉट इक्वल टू हाउ मच. इट शुड बी अब देखिए इसके लिए अगर आई नॉट निकालना है तो मुझे पहले तो ये हो जाएगा, देखिए इसके लिए कितना मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया होगा, दैट इज हाफ एम आर स्क्वायर, सो आई कैन से दैट इट शुड बी एम आर स्क्वायर बाई टू प्लस. अब अगेन यू हैव टू अप्लाई दिस सेम पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम, कैसे, थ्रू इच स्फेयर व्हाट इज द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, दैट इज एम आर स्क्वायर बाई टू, एंड यहाँ से जो डिस्टेंस होगा दैट विल बी टू आर. इसके लिए भी सेम होगा. अगर हम बात करें तो यहाँ पर भी देखिए इसके लिए भी 2R, इसके लिए भी 2R. इट मीन्स आई कैन से दैट देयर आर सिक्स स्फीयर हियर, सो दिस विल बी 6 इंटू एम आर स्क्वायर बाई टू प्लस एम इंटू 2R होल स्क्वायर. अंडरस्टूड? पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम जस्ट अप्लाइंग. सो हियर यू विल गेट आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन यू विल गेट दिस 55 बाई 2 एम आर स्क्वायर, दैट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आई नॉट हियर. अब देखो यहाँ पे ये जो आई नॉट मिला दैट इज द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया अबाउट दिस पॉइंट टू परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन, बट वी हैव टू फाइंड द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया अबाउट दिस पॉइंट पी परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन. सो आई कैन अप्लाई दिस अकॉर्डिंग टू पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम. दिस आई पी इक्वल टू आई नॉट प्लस, अब देखिए यहाँ पे टोटल मास कितना मिलेगा मेरे को 7 एम हियर इनटू डिस्टेंस कितना होगा यहाँ पे 2R स्क्वायर, सॉरी distance will be this is 2R and this is R, so it should be 7m into 3R whole square, so it should be how much, it should be 55 by 2 mr square plus 63 mr square, so it's from here we will get the value of IP, that is IP equal to how much, IP equal to 181 by 2 mr square. That is the value of moment of inertia about this point P here. So let us take which one is the right answer. It is option number P here. So this is P1. Now we'll move to the question number 17 here. That is the very easy one. Three concentric metal cell A, B, and C of respective radius A, B, and C, where A is less than B, B is less than C here, having surface charge density plus minus plus. The potential of the cell B is. Ab dekho yahan pe. Pehle to diagram bana lo. जो ए का रेडियस है दैट इज सबसे कम वाला रेडियस है, तो यहां पे आई विल राइट दिस इज ए, दिस इज बी एंड दिस इज सी हियर. दिस वन हैविंग रेडियस ऑफ ए, दिस वन हैविंग रेडियस ऑफ बी एंड दिस वन हैविंग रेडियस ऑफ सी हियर. अब देखो पोटेंशियल क्या होता है, क्यू अपन 4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट आर हियर. अब सरफेस चार्ज डेंसिटी इज गिवन, सो आई विल अप्लाई दिस वन, दिस पोटेंशियल इज के क्यू ए अपॉन बी हियर, के क्यू ए अपॉन बी, और के क्यू अपॉन आर, दिस इज अ बेसिक फॉर्मूला. अब देखो यहां पे टोटल पोटेंशियल वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, सो टोटल पोटेंशियल विल बी वी टोटल इक्वल टू हाउ मच. अब देखो यहां पे व्हाट इज द रेडियस हियर, अगर मैं ए के लिए बात करूं तो यहां पे जो रेडियस होगा इसके लिए इस पॉइंट पे हमको निकालना कहां पे पोटेंशियल, पोटेंशियल एट स्फीयर बी पे, सेल बी पे निकालना, तो बी के लिए जो रेडियस होगा रेडियस विल बी बी ओनली, एंड सॉरी फॉर ए रेडियस विल बी बी, कैसे कि देखो अगर मैं सेल ए की बात करूं तो वहां पे जो चार्ज होगा दैट इज द सिग्मा ए प्लस सिग्मा, बट रेडियस विल बी बी ओनली. अगर मैं बी सेल की बात करूं तो वहां पे भी रेडियस बी ही होगा, डिस्टेंस विल बी बी, एंड फॉर सी इट विल बी सी ओनली. देखो यहां पे वी टोटल वी कैन से के क्यू ए अपॉन बी प्लस के क्यू बी अपॉन बी प्लस के क्यू सी अपॉन सी हियर. अब नाउ हाउ यू कैन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू ए हियर, सरफेस चार्ज डेंसिटी इज गिवन दैट इज सिग्मा, सो सिग्मा इंटू 4 पाई आर स्क्वायर, और चार्ज पर यूनिट एरिया, सो आई कैन से दैट सिग्मा इंटू 4 पाई आर स्क्वायर दैट विल बी, दैट विल गिव द रेडियस, दैट विल गिव द टोटल चार्ज, सो हियर इट शुड बी के इंटू सिग्मा, that is the 4 pi a square plus divided by b here plus k into 4 pi b square divided by b plus ab into ab dekho yahan pe minus sigma, it is given that it is minus sigma, so I can write this is minus sigma plus k into 4 pi c square into it is plus sigma here, divided by C here. That is value of V total here. Understood? Now, here it should be, after calculation you will get, you can take K common, sigma common, anything else you can take? No. K sigma you can take common here, you will get A square by B, B say B it will cancel out minus B plus C, sorry it should be C only, right? K sigma this one, so from here you can find the final value, that is, up K key value you can say 4 pi epsilon naught. So it should be sigma by epsilon naught into A square minus B square divided by B plus C here. Dekho kaise, here we will get 4 pi here also, sorry here not here, here you will get 4 pi. Dekho K key value agar put karoge 4 pi, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi will get cancelled out. So you will get only sigma by epsilon naught A square minus B square by B plus C here. And which is the right answer? Sigma by epsilon A square minus B square by B plus C. That is the option number D only, right? Now, question number 18 here. Ab yahan pe dekho. In a potentiometer experiment, it is found that no current passes through the galvanometer when the terminal of the cell are connected across 52 cm of the potentiometer wire. Ab dekho, yahan pe apne ye padha hai ki potential difference is directly proportional to the length of the potentiometer, or I can say that this EMF of the battery is equal to how much? That is 52x proportional to 52x or equal to 52x. This is equation number 1. Ab dekho yahan pe. If the cell is shunted by a resistance of 5 ohm, a balance is found when the cell is connected across 40 cm of the wire. Ab jab aap yahan pe ek wire lagaoge, to what is the current induced? I equal to E upon R plus 5 here. Or ab jab aapne yahan pe battery laga diya, to net potential difference will be I minus IR. होगा देखो ये तो करंट की वैल्यू है E अपॉन R प्लस 5 बट जब आपने यहाँ पे एक एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस लगाया तो जो करंट होगा दैट इज E माइनस आई आर दैट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू 40 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ द दिस वन सो 40x जस्ट पुट ऑन द वैल्यूज ऑफ I हियर I माइनस E अपॉन R प्लस 5 इंटू R हियर दैट इज इक्वल टू 40x अब जब इसको सॉल्व करोगे तो ER एंड ER विल कैंसिल आउट यू विल गेट 5E divided by R plus 5 that is equal to 40x. This is equation number 2. So after solving equation number 1 and 2 you will get R equal to how much? R equal to 1.5 ohm. The two equation two unknowns are there. So R equal to 1.5 and which one is the right answer? This is option number D here. So it will be D option. Let's move to the next one, that is option number, sorry, question number 19 here. And EMF wave or electromagnetic wave from air enter a medium, the electric field are given that E1 equal to E0 x cos 2 pi v z by c minus t in air and E2 equal to this one in medium where the wave number k and frequency v refer to their values in air here. The medium is non-magnetic. If ER1 and ER2, epsilon R1 and ER2 refer to the relative permittivity of air and medium respectively, which of the following option is correct one? Ab dekhiye yahan pe. First of all, just try to find the इसका एक बेसिक क्वेश्चन याद करो E इक्वल टू E नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी माइनस सॉरी के एक्स माइनस ओमेगा टी दिस इज द वैल्यू हियर E इक्वल टू E नॉट सॉरी शुड बी E इक्वल टू E नॉट साइन के एक्स माइनस ओमेगा टी हियर व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ओमेगा हियर ओमेगा इक्वल टू 2 पाई वी सो आई कैन से दैट दिस ओमेगा इक्वल टू 2 पाई वी हियर व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के हियर के इक्वल टू V upon C here. यहाँ पे देखो, this is equation number one, this is equation number two here. Okay, so K equal to 2 pi V upon C. अब for this one, E2 equal to. अब देखो यहाँ पे I can say that K equal to how much? K equal to for second case I can say K dash equal to how much? K dash equal to 2 only, right? Nothing is there. Minus and omega equal to how much? Omega equal to K C here. Should be 2k and omega equal to omega dash equal to 2c here. Okay, ab dekho yahan pe the medium is non magnetic. If ER1 you are given that this one, so you have to do this one. So I can say that k equal to how much? K equal to where is the value here? Yes, k equal to omega dash upon k here, k equal to omega dash upon k, or you can say that this will be C dash here. It should be actually here it is, it should be C. So in the next so basically we got this k equal to how much? K equal to omega by c, k dash equal to how much? K dash equal to omega by c dash, and omega by c dash equal to 2 omega by c here. Why? Dekho yahan pe. It should be 2k. So 2 omega by c, and from here we can say c dash equal to c by 2. Ab dekho yahan pe speed of light, there is one formula here, c equal to 1 upon under root mu into epsilon root. Padha samne? To yahan pe in case of medium and in case of air, we can write this formula, c dash equal to how much? C dash equal to 1 upon epsilon naught, this mu into mu r, mu naught into mu r1 into E naught into E r1 equal to 1 upon 2 under root 1 upon mu naught epsilon naught, because this is the value in air only. Ab dekhiye yahan pe, air and medium are non-magnetic, or you can say that this is mu r1 and E r1 here. Just take as a, this one is a 2 and this is 2 here. This is 1 and this is 1 here also. Ab dekho, for air and medium is non-magnetic. It means we can say mu r1 equal to mu r2, that is equal to 1 here. Because this is non-magnetic case. So here we got, doing after this one I'm doing here, you will get 1 upon E r2, that is equal to 1 upon 4 upon 1 upon 4 E r1. Kaise square both side, you will get this one. So 1 upon E r2 equal to 1 upon E r1. So E r1 upon E r2 equal to 1 upon 4 here. E r1 upon E r2 equal to 1 upon 4. So let us check which one is the right answer actually. E r1 upon E r2 equal to 1 upon 4. That is option number A here. So option number A is the right one. Yes. Now 20 number. The angular width of the central maximum is given in a single slit diffraction pattern is given 60 degree. So theta equal to how much? That is pi by 3, that is lambda upon a, or 2 lambda upon a, that is equal to pi by 3 here. Getting my point? Ab dekho yahan pe, the width of the slit is given 1 micrometer. The slit is illuminated by monochromatic plane wave. If another slit of same width is made near it, Young's freeze can be observed on a screen placed at a distance of 50 centimeter. So here d is how much? D is 50 centimeter. If the observed fringe width is given 1 centimeter, beta is how much? Beta is 1 centimeter. What is the slit separation distance? Now you have to find the small d here. Now yahan pe dekhiye, what is the value of beta here? It should be lambda d upon d here. And from here we can find the value of lambda, that is pi a upon 6. So I can say that beta is how much? 1 centimeter equal to lambda is pi a upon 6 into d is how much? D is given 50 centimeter, and you have to find the value of d here, and a is also given, a is 1 micrometer. So just put on the values of a also, you can write 1 micrometer. So here only one unknown is d here. So from after calculation you get d equal to how much? D equal to 25 micrometer. So after calculation d you get 25 micrometer here. Option number which one? C option. Yes. 21. A silver atom in a solid oscillates in a single harmonic motion in some direction with a frequency of 10 raised to 12 second. What is the force constant? Force constant means K of the bond connecting one atom with another. A molecular weight of the silver is given, this one. Avogadro number is given, this one. Ab dekho yahan pe what you have to do? We know that ki omega equal to how much? Omega equal to 2 pi f here. And here f is given, so I can say that omega will be 2 pi into 10 raised to 12, that is it should be 2 pi into 10 raised to 12 here. Ab dekho omega equal to how much? Omega square equal to m, sorry, it should be mk square, right? Omega equal to, sorry, k equal to m omega square. This is the formula for force constant. And here mass is how much? Mass you have to find, this 108 divided by 6.02 into 10 raised to 23 gram per mole. So you have to multiply by the 10 raised to minus 3 also, 10 raised to 3 also, to convert into kg, into omega square. It should be 2 pi into 10 raised to 12 square here. From here, k equal to how much? After doing calculation and all, you will get k equal to 7.1 Newton per meter. That is option number D here. Okay, fine. We will move to the next one. Before that one, let me check which one is the right hand side. It is option number D. Now, 22 number. From a uniform circular disc of radius r and mass 9m, a small disc of radius r by 3 is removed. As shown in the figure, the moment of inertia of the remaining disc about an axis perpendicular to the plane of the disc and passing through the center of the disc. देखो पहले तो ये calculate करो कि what is the moment of inertia of the total disc before removing the this one. So I can say that it will be how much? 9m r square. अब यहाँ से दिस इज द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया अबाउट द सेंटर. अब ये जो पार्ट आपने रिमूव किया है इसका मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया माइनस कर दो. कैसे? इसके मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया अबाउट द सेंटर स्मॉल वन अबाउट द सेंटर रेडियस कितना आर बाई थ्री प्लस यू कैन अप्लाई दिस पैरेलल सिस्टम. सो आई कैन से दैट 9m दैट इज आई डैश इक्वल टू 9m आर स्क्वायर माइनस इसका दैट इज m इंटू आर बाई थ्री. तो r by 3 होल स्क्वायर प्लस m इंटू 2r by 3 होल स्क्वायर. क्लियर हो रहा है कि देखो यहाँ पे फाइंड द टोटल मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया ऑफ द यूनिफॉर्म डिस्क ऑफ रेडियस r दैट इज 9m r स्क्वायर माइनस. अब देखो यहाँ से आपने इसको रिमूव किया तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस इज द डिस्क दिस इज द होल हियर. तो होल का इसके अबाउट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया निकालो उसको सब्ट्रैक्ट करो. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा इसका मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया दैट इज m इंटू r by 3 whole square. अब देखो यहाँ पे r by 3 and this is r, so total mass will be 9m, so mass total mass will be m only, so mass will be m. So here I can say m into r by 3 का whole square plus m into 2r by 3 का whole square. You will get this one. From here you can find the value of after doing calculation after solving this expression you will get m equal to 4m r square. That is the value of I dash here. Option number C. This is C is the right one. Let's move to question number 23. अब देखो 23 में कुछ भी दिया हुआ नहीं है. यहाँ पे क्या करना है? इन ए कोलिनियर कोलिजन ए पार्टिकल विद इनिशियल स्पीड ऑफ v नॉट स्ट्राइक ए स्टेशनरी पार्टिकल ऑफ सेम मास. देखो दिस इज द वन पार्टिकल हियर हैविंग मास ऑफ m. दिस अनदर सेम पार्टिकल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो. इट्स वेलोसिटी इज गिवन दैट इज v नॉट हियर. मास इज ऑल्सो सेम. इफ द फाइनल टोटल काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज 50% ग्रेटर देन द ओरिजिनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी. अब देखो व्हाट इज ओरिजिनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी? इट इज हाफ m v नॉट स्क्वायर. नहीं नहीं रॉन्ग हो गया. सो दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज रॉन्ग हियर. फाइनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी व्हाट इज एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ फाइनल काइनेटिक एनर्जी आफ्टर कोलिजन? सो लेट्स अज्यूम दैट कि आफ्टर कोलिजन इट्स वेलोसिटी इज v1 फॉर मास m and for second mass its velocity is v2 here for mass m here, right? Ab dekho yahan pe what is the total kinetic energy after collision? It should be half m v1 square plus half m v2 square. That is equal to 50% greater than the original kinetic energy, that is 1.5 m v0 square by 2 here. Ab dekho this is a case of collision, so we can apply this momentum conservation formula, that is m v0 equal to m v1 plus m v2. Okay, from here we can find the v2 plus v1, that is equal to v1. And what is the value of v2 here? V2 equal to how much? That is v0 minus v1. Now let's assume this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2 here, right? Ab yahan pe you can see that ki v1 square plus v2 square, that is equal to v0 square here. Understood? Ab dekho yahan pe just put on the values of v2 here. So I can say v1 square plus v0 minus v1 all square, that is equal to v0 square. It should be 1.5 v1 square here. Ab dekho here we will get v1 square plus v1 minus 1.5 v1 square from 0. Ab here we are getting the quadratic equation in terms of v1 square. So whenever you will find the roots of this quadratic equation, you will get two roots, that is a v1 and v2. and here we can say alpha minus beta equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. And from here you can find the value of alpha beta, that is b by a, and alpha beta, alpha plus beta minus b by a, and alpha beta c by a here. So this is the value of v1 v2 minus v1, that is equal to, after this putting the all the values from here, you can find the direct value, that is root 2 by 4, I think. Yes, it should be, what is the final answer for this one? It should be root 2 by v0. That is the velocity of the separation, or relative velocity you can say. Okay, so it should be root 2 v0 here. 24. Ab dekho, the dipole moment of a circular loop carrying a current I is m. So what is the dipole moment m? M equal to how much? M equal to I into a here. So let's assume that ki I into, for m here, I into pi r1 square. That is the value of m. What about m dash? M dash dekho yahan pe kya hoga? When the dipole moment is double, by keeping the current constant, the magnetic field at the center of the loop is b2. Ab dekho yahan pe m dash ko kya kar rahe ho aap? 2m kar rahe ho. That is equal to I into pi into r2 square. I'm just, let's assume this is equation number 1, this is 2, so can I say 2 by 1 equal to how much? It should be 2m upon m, that is equal to r2 square upon r1 square, so I can say r2 equal to how much? r2 equal to root 2 r1, r2 equal to root 2 r1, ab dekho yahan pe, what is the value of magnetic field at center? It should be b1 equal to how much? It should be b1 equal to mu naught I upon 2 r1, what is the b2? b2 equal to mu naught I upon 2 r2 here, understood? Mu naught I upon 2 r1, mu naught I upon 2 r2 here. We have to find the ratio of b1 upon b2, so I can say that b1 upon b2 equal to how much? r2 upon r1, that is the value of root 2 here. So this is the final value, it is only root 2. Option number A is the right one only. Okay, now we'll move to the question number 25. It is here now. The density of the material is given in the shape of cube is given by the measuring three sides of the cube and its mass here. So what is the value of density? That is m upon v here. We have to find the maximum error in the determining the density here. So I can say that it should be, ab dekho yahan pe, agar mujhe direct d rho upon rho nikalna tha, I can write dm upon m plus dv upon v here. But there is given that in terms of error, in terms of mass and length here. So I can say this is mass upon L cube. So now it should be equal to dm upon m plus 3 delta L upon L here. So it should be delta m upon m is given 1.5 plus 3 into 1. It should be 4.5%. That is option number A is the 4.5%. Understood? So this is the relative error in density. 4.5% here. Okay. Now, question number 26 here. That is option number A is the right one. On interchanging the resistance, the balance point of a meter brace shifts to the left by 10 centimeter. The resistance of their series combination is 1 kilo ohm. How much was the resistance on the left slot before interchanging the resistance? Ab dekho, yahan pe aapko basic concept yaad rakhna padega ki before interchanging, what is the expression for this balance point of meter brace? That is equal to how much? Let's assume that the resistance in left and right is equal to R and 1000 minus R cube, because the total is given 1000. This is 1000 ohm here. So I can say that initially it should be R into 1000 minus X, that is equal to 1000 minus R into X here. अब देखो, ये तो initial after interchanging, जब आपने इसको interchange किया, जब आपको इसको interchange करोगे, तो what you will get? You will get R into 1000 minus R into 100 minus X minus 10, because यहाँ पे there is a shift of 10, कहाँ गया, there is a left side, shift to the left side by 10 centimeter here, that is equal to how much, equal to r into x minus 10, this is equation number 2 here, this is equation number 1 here. अब देखो यहाँ पे, from 1 and 2 you can find the value of here, कैसे, here just multiply by this one, I can say that this is 1000 r minus r x equal to how much, equal to 1000 x minus r x. Why it is same? Yes, it should be 100 minus x, not 1000 actually, it should be 100 minus x. So here it will be, this is this one, 100 r equal to this one, so I can say that r equal to 10 x here, okay, 100 r minus r x equal to 1000 x minus r x. So here, from here you can find the value of r, that is 10 x here. Kaise, dekho r x ko idhar leke jao, r x ko, it should be 2 r x equal to 1000 r x into x, r plus x, so you will get r equal to 10 x here. Ab isko jo r ki value, isko equation number 2 mein put karo, from there you can find the value of x r, that is equal to 550 ohm here. Okay, just put on the values of x in the question number 2 here. Jahan bhi x hai wahan pe, to wahan pe aapko milega quadratic equation milega. From there you can find the value of r, that is 550 ohm here. Yes, 550 ohm. Ab let us move to the next one, that is in AC circuit. This is a question of alternative current. देखो, what is given in an AC circuit, the instantaneous EMF and current are given by E equal to 100 sin 30 t and I is given, that is 20 sin 30 t minus pi by 4, so there is a phase difference here. In one cycle of AC, the average power consumed by the circuit and the wattless current, अब देखो average power कैसे होगा, average power will be, I can say P average, that is equal to V RMS into I RMS into cos phi, सबको पता है. अब व्हाट इज द वैल्यू वी आर एम एस, दैट इज द 100 बाई रूट टू इंटू आई आर एम एस, दैट इज 20 बाई रूट टू एंड फेज डिफरेंस फाइव, दैट इज द कॉस पाई बाई 4 ईयर, सो इट शुड बी कॉस पाई बाई 4. अब देखो माइनस पाई बाई 4 भी लोगे तब भी सेम होगा, कॉस माइनस थीटा इक्वल टू कॉस थीटा, सो हियर इट शुड बी 2000 अपॉन 2 रूट 2 ईयर, दैट इज द 1000 अपॉन रूट 2, सो इट शुड बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच, 1000 अपॉन रूट टू, जस्ट टेक एज, बिकॉज देखो यहाँ पे ऑप्शन नंबर डी. अब वाटलेस करंट देखो क्या होता है, वाटलेस करंट जो होगा वो आई इक्वल टू वाटलेस करंट, दैट इज आई आर एम एस इन टू साइन फाइव, एंड वाट इज वैल्यू ऑफ आई आर एम एस, दैट इज 20 अपॉन रूट टू इन टू साइन 45 इज 1 अपॉन रूट टू, सो यू विल गेट 10 एम्पियर. ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज द राइट वन ओनली. अगर आप पहला भी निकालोगे 1000 अपॉन रूट टू, देखो मोस्टली वाटलेस करंट कहीं भी पढ़ाया नहीं जाता है, ठीक है, तो अगर आपको यहाँ पे पावर कंज्यूम एवरेज पावर का फॉर्मूला पता है तो वहाँ पे आप 1000 अपॉन रूट टू, एंड देयर इज ओनली वन ऑप्शन इज हियर, सो यू कैन इजली मार्क दिस ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज द राइट वन. फाइन, नाउ दिस इज द राइट आंसर एक्चुअली 28 हियर. अब देखो ये बहुत ही इजी प्रॉब्लम है, ऑल द ग्राफ विल आर इंटेंडेड टू रिप्रेजेंट द सेम मोशन, वन ऑफ देम डज इट इनकरेक्टली, पिक इट अप, यू हैव टू फाइंड द विच वन इज अ रॉन्ग डायग्राम. अब देखो दिस इज द पोजिशन टाइम ग्राफ, आफ्टर इंक्रीजिंग द टाइम योर पोजिशन इज इंक्रीजिंग, सॉरी इट विल रीच अप टू मैक्सिमम पॉइंट, अगेन इट इज कमिंग बैक टू द इनिशियल पॉइंट. कैसे, देखो अगर आप किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट को ऊपर फेंकोगे, तो जब आप ऊपर फेंकोगे तो वहाँ पर क्या होगा, इस पर आपका टाइम के साथ डिस्टेंस इंक्रीज होगा, पोजिशन इंक्रीज होगा अप टू मैक्सिमम पॉइंट, इसके बाद अगेन यू विल कम बैक टू द इनिशियल पॉइंट, राइट, ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर दिस वन इज द राइट वन. वेलासिटी डायग्राम, वेलासिटी कैसे होगा, टाइम के साथ डिक्रीज होगा, उसके बाद एक पॉइंट पे जीरो आएगा, उसके बाद अगेन इट विल स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग, दैट इज द दिस वन इज आल्सो करेक्ट वन. अब यहाँ पे देखो वेलोसिटी पोजीशन ग्राफ, ये भी सही है. कैसे, देखो वेलोसिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग व्हेन यू इंक्रीज द पोजीशन, बट एक सर्टेन पॉइंट पे, मैक्सिमम पॉइंट पे इसकी वेलोसिटी जीरो होगी, अगेन इट्स पोजीशन विल डिक्रीज व्हेन यू विल कमिंग डाउन, बट योर पोजीशन विल, योर वेलोसिटी विल इंक्रीज. द ऑप्शन नंबर सी इज आल्सो राइट वन, द डी ऑप्शन इज द रॉन्ग वन, सो दिस इज द रॉन्ग वन, बिकॉज देयर इज नो एनी रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस, देयर इज नो एनी रिलेशन of this graph here. So option D is the wrong one. Let us take which one is the wrong one. It is D1. ठीक है, कितना देखो कितना इजी प्रॉब्लम था. काइनेमेटिक्स का सबसे बेसिक प्रॉब्लम है मोशन अंडर ग्रेविटी का. ठीक है, चलो द नेक्स्ट वन इज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 19 हियर. टू मोल्स ऑफ एन आइडियल मोनोटॉमिक गैस ऑक्युपाई अ वॉल्यूम वी एट 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस. द गैस एक्सपैंड एडियाबेटिकली. अब देखो यहाँ पे गैस इज एक्सपैंडिंग एडियाबेटिकली टू वॉल्यूम ऑफ 2V. तो इनिशियल वॉल्यूम वॉज वी एंड फाइनल वॉल्यूम इज 2V हियर, बट फाइनल टेम्परेचर इज नॉट गिवन. तो कैसे निकालोगे? So then if it is adiabatic, I can say PV equal to gamma equal to constant, or I can take as this one concept. Just put on PV equal to nRT. So just remove this P. So P, I can say P equal to T by V here. So here I can say T into V upon gamma divided by V equal to constant here. Or you will get T into V equal to gamma minus 1 equal to C. This is the expression for adiabatic expression. Now I can say T1 into V1 gamma minus 1 equal to T2 V2 gamma minus 1 here. And we have to find the value of T2 here. So T2 equal to how much? T2 equal to T1 into V1 upon V2. T1 V1 upon V2 gamma minus 1. And what is the value of T2? T1 here, T1 is 27 degrees Celsius, it should be 300 Kelvin into V upon 2V into 1.4 minus 1. Gamma is given? Gamma is not given, but it's the ideal monatomic gas. I will take 1.4 here. So you have to take this one, or it's a monatomic gas, so gamma will be 2 by 3 here. So I can say that it will be 2 by 3. If nothing is given, we will use the same concept, that is gamma minus 1, that is 2 by 3 minus 1. So here you will get V upon 2V, that is the value of T. T is equal to 189 Kelvin here. Okay, now ab dekho yahan pe, why it is should be 5 by 4, right? Take as a 1.4 only. Okay, don't be confused. Actually 2 by 3 you will get 0.4. 1.4, so 3 by 2, 2 by 2, 2 by 3. Okay, so here we will get T2, we got T2 equal to 189 Kelvin. Now, because we have to find the final temperature is how much, it should be 189 Kelvin here, that is 189 Kelvin, 189 Kelvin. So these two options will be wrong here, understood? Now, look here. Minus 2.7 kilojoule or 2.7 kilojoule, which one is the right one? Ab jo change in its internal energy, and here temperature is decreasing. Temperature is decreasing here, 300 Kelvin to 189 Kelvin here. So it should be work done should be less, or it should be negative here. So option number A is the right one, minus 2.7. But dekho, ab yahan pe work done kaise nikaloge? There is a direct formula, that is delta U equal to how much? It should be N 3 by 2 R delta T. So 3 by 2 is the value of gamma here, okay? So it's n into 3 by 2 r delta t. Just put down the values of n here. N is how much? N is 2 given, 2 moles. Dekho yahan pe 2 moles. So n is 2 into 3 by 2, and so gamma is 3 by 2 r. That is the diatomic gas. It's a diatomic gas or monatomic? It's a monatomic gas. So we will take 2 by 3, 3 by 2 r here. That is the value of 3 by 2 r. That is a 3 by 2. Into R into delta T. Delta T is 189 minus 300. From here you will get delta U equal to how much? Delta U equal to minus 2768 or 2.7 kilojoule. That option number A is the right answer. Now we will move to the next one. That is the last problem of today class. That is the question number 30. Finally we have reached. Yes, a particle is moving with a uniform speed in a circular orbit. Whenever we talk about the circular motion, F equal to m v square by r here, and here it is force is inversely proportional to the nth power of r. So I can say F is inversely proportional to 1 upon r n, or I can say F equal to k upon r n here, k upon r n here. Ab dekho yahan pe, if the period of rotation of the force is given t, ab F equal to k upon r n, or I can say that m v square upon r here, m v square upon r. So what is the value of v here? V square equal to, we can say that it should be k upon m into 1 upon r raised to n minus 1. Understood? R raised to n minus 1, or I can say that v is proportional to 1 upon r raised to n minus 1 divided by 2. It's getting complicated. Right? I can say v is proportional to r raised to 1 minus n upon 2. कैसे देखो यहाँ पे 1 अपॉन आर है तो इसको ऊपर लेके जाओगे तो माइनस वन सो एन माइनस वन रेस टू माइनस वन इट शुड बी 1 माइनस एन अपॉन टू हियर दैट्स व्हाई आई एम रीडिंग 1 माइनस एन अपॉन टू हियर अब देखो वी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर रेस टू 1 माइनस एन अपॉन टू व्हाट इज द वैल्यू एक्सप्रेशन हियर यू हैव टू फाइंड द पीरियड ऑफ रोटेशन दैट इज टी सो टी इक्वल टू 2 पाई आर अपॉन वी 2 पाई आर अपॉन वी दैट इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 2 पाई आर अपॉन वी एंड वी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1 माइनस आर रेस टू 1 minus n by 2, so I can say that t is proportional to r raised to 1 plus n by 2 here. कैसे? इसको आप ऊपर लेके जाओगे तो 1 minus n upon 2, so you will get to r raised to 1 plus n raised to 2. So here we can say this is the t, so time period is proportional to r raised to 1 plus n by 2. That is the value of this one, the option number t is proportional to r is to n plus 1 by 2. That is option number A is the right one. Okay, so guys, in today's class, we have discussed the complete paper of 2018 physics mains paper of this 2018. Okay, I hope everyone will understood my today discussion. If you are still having any kind of doubts, please come to my class. Okay, we are giving the classes for this physics, IIT JEE and NEET classes for this 2020 because already we have given the class for 2019 batch. So still 2020 batch is going on. If you are having any kind of doubts, please attend our classes, attend my class, physics class, okay? And till for the next paper, final paper of 2019, all the very best. Please do well and please don't demotivate, okay? You have still 10 or 15 days, utilize your time. That is very important. And this 15 days is very crucial for you, crucial for you actually. So please utilize that time. We'll meet again in somewhere. Bye-bye. Take care. Good. Take care, all the best.